So you've decided to take the AP Environmental Science exam. Folks, this is great. The world definitely needs more people who understand topics like energy transfer and interactions among species, and most importantly, sustainability. Of course, taking this class also means that you'll have to sit for the AP exam. But that's good news too. You could potentially earn a couple of semesters worth of college credits. This is awesome, a time saver and a money saver. Folks, there is no need to stress about this exam. Let's break it down together. And when we're done breaking it down here, remember that you can pick up where we've left off together by picking up a copy of our fully updated for 2020 Cracking the AP Environmental Science Guidebook. Now, the AP Environmental Science exam is a breezy 2 hours and 40 minutes. It's also given at noon, a very acceptable testing hour, if I do say so myself. And like so many other great exams that have come before it, the AP Environmental Science exam is divided into a multiple choice and free response section, both of which will be changing a bit in 2020. But have no fear, that's why we're here and talking about this together. I'm going to walk you through those changes so that by the time this video is done, you'll have a handle on what is this newfangled exam and what it will look like. Spoiler alert, folks, the test changes are really good news for you. Let's dive right into the multiple choice section. So right off the bat, I'll just let you know that a few aspects are remaining the same. Chiefly, you'll still have 1 hour and 30 minutes to tackle the questions. And this section will continue to count for 60% of your overall score. So what's changing exactly? Well, previous exams had students answer 100 questions. There were no text-based stimulus. That's the test maker speech for passage. Each question had 5 possible answer choices. Now, as of May 2020, the number of questions is dropping to 80. Now you'll have a little more breathing room. You'll go from having 54 seconds per question to having 67.5 seconds per question, which for a large number of questions is a lot more time. Awesome. And since every problem will have only 4 possible answer options, it will be easier for you to take an educated guess to determine the correct answer through process of elimination. It almost is like the test takers want you to succeed on this exam. Folks, I can't speak for them, but we at the Princeton Review definitely want you to succeed on this exam, and we know you can do it. There will also be a number of new questions. Going forward, you'll be asked to answer 2 sets of questions that are text-based. These will test your ability to analyze and evaluate sources. This updated exam will also place equal weight on quantitative and qualitative data. So you'll have to assess quantitative data such as charts and graphs and data tables, as well as qualitative data such as maps and models and representations. There will be 3 or 4 sets each of these question types. I think we're ready to move on to the free response section. Time sure does fly by, folks, a concept that our buddies at the AP Physics are probably thinking about right now. As I already mentioned, the free response questions are also changing. In years past, this section contained 4 questions that were the same combination of document-based questions, database question, and 2 questions that required synthesis and evaluation. Students were given 1 hour and 30 minutes to tackle everything. Starting this May, you'll only have to answer 3 questions, but don't start celebrating too quickly. The time has also been adjusted. You'll only have 1 hour and 10 minutes to complete everything. And to my mind, this is also good news for you. It is less of a marathon. As for the specific free response questions, the first one will ask you to design an investigation of some sort. The second will have you assess an environmental problem and then generate a possible solution. And the third and final question will be similar to the second, but you'll have to propose a solution using calculations. The free response section will be worth 40% of your overall score. Now, that's a significant portion, so it's worth your while to produce thoughtful, carefully considered responses to each of the 3 questions. And since we're on the good news train today, now will be a good time for me to mention that you'll be allowed to bring a calculator to this AP exam and to use it on both sections. This is a new and very welcome policy. To get your stellar prep for this exam, we at the Princeton Review have released our fully updated Cracking the AP Environmental Science book. It's the 2020 edition. The content review is fantastic. You'll even get 2 full-length practice tests so you can sharpen your skill and get ready to earn your 5. Folks, remember to subscribe to our channel for all of the latest AP exam updates. You'll also find a ton of great college content and lots of other stuff too. Folks, as always, thanks for watching.